Very pleasant good morning to all of you, dear students. Welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. As we are discussing about the effects of water pollution, in the previous lecture we was just outlined or illustrated or analyzed the effects of water pollution. Today we will try to discuss the effects of water pollution in detail one by one. So let us start. Today we are going to discuss about eutrophication. What actually eutrophication means? Actually it consists of two different words and is derived from Greek word eu means true and trops means nutrient, or collectively we say truly nourishedly, we can say truly nourished water bodies. Truly nourished water bodies. Eutrophication is the process of nutrient enrichment of water bodies due to addition of nitrates and phosphates, either from due to cultural activities or from natural activities. As we are applying so many fertilizers in our agriculture field, NPK fertilizers, phosphate is there, super phosphate is there, urea is there, and so many other fertilizers we apply to boost up the productivity of the crop. And after the application of fertilizers, what happens with the fertilizers is it get dissolved during the course of irrigation or during the course of precipitation, it gets made their way towards the nearest water bodies through runoff, and on reaching water bodies, the phytoplanktons existing here results excessive amount of growth, and sometimes the azolla on the surface of the earth, gets excessively exploded, and we call these algal bloom. In simply, we can say eutrophication is the process of nutrient enrichment of water bodies, which results due to addition of nutrients like phosphate and nitrates from the nearest agricultural fields or from any other source. So, how we can define the eutrophication? Eutrophication, we can simply define eutrophication, or we can also say hypertrophication. It also means, hyper means excessive amount of, trophication, trops means nutrients is available, nutrients are available there. Eutrophication is excessive nutrient enrichment of water body due to addition of nutrients, as I already told you, due to addition of nutrients from nearby sources, be it agricultural field, be it industries, or be it domestic sources, any type of source, results in depletion of oxygen, with increase in algal growth, which we call as algal bloom, and increases phytoplankton, because these are plants. Actually we are getting nutrients from nearby areas, which results the growth of phytoplankton. Actually phyto, because the plant, these are plants, and they are actually getting nutrients, as a result of which the plants get increased, phytoplanktons get increased, which we say algal bloom. So what actually eutrophication means? Eutrophication or hypertrophication is the excessive nutrient enrichment. Nutrients, I already told you, it may be nitrogen, it may be phosphate, it may be carbon, and many other nutrients is adding from different source. Nutrient enrichment of water body due to addition of nutrients from nearby sources, resulting in depletion of oxygen and algal bloom increase or phytoplankton increase. Now, how the dissolved oxygen gets decreases actually. As we all know, water body favors the growth of algal bloom. And what these are actually? These are actually biotic component. Biotic components, after the death of these phytoplanktons, or maybe the zooplanktons, maybe the small fish or large fish, these biodegradable substances get accumulate here. Accumulation of biodegradable substances in a water body in lakes takes place, and the amount of dissolved oxygen, say for example we have 14 milligram per liter of water, if we have before the nutrients are received by the water body, then they, after the death of these biotic components, be it phytoplankton, zooplankton, small fish or large fish, it consumes oxygen for decomposing itself to release nutrients, and during the course of decomposition, what happens? Oxygen, or dissolved oxygen, we say dissolved oxygen in the water body is used for decomposition process. As a result, the amount of oxygen may get depleted from 14 to 10 milligram per liter of water, or 8 milligram per liter of water, 7 milligrams per liter of water. Means amount of oxygen, dissolved oxygen gets declined or reduced due to excessive consumption of dissolved oxygen for decomposition process in the water bodies. So there are two different types of eutrophication. One is natural eutrophication and another one is cultural eutrophication. Natural eutrophication is actually also a type of eutrophication where there is the lakes get nutrients from the nearest sources, but the source must be natural in nature. For example, the rocks, we have different types of nutrients, and on precipitation different amount of different nutrients get dissolved by natural means and reach in the nearest water bodies and results natural eutrophication. But we have to keep in mind that natural eutrophication is very negligible process, very negligible contribution. Hence, natural eutrophication is not going to affect the quality of water because of very slow process of addition of nutrients or through any other mechanism. Means simply natural eutrophication is the process of eutrophication by natural means without any intervention or without any interference of human being. And no negative effect is going to result in case of natural eutrophication. While in case of cultural eutrophication is actually the process of eutrophication where there is a strong human activity is involved for increasing the nutrient content in the water bodies. How human beings are actually adding nutrients in the water bodies? As already told you, we are applying fertilizers in the water bodies. Fertilizers may be, for example, NPK fertilizers are there. There may be urea we have, we may have phosphate, we may have superphosphate. these are the nutrients actually we are adding during the course of the agricultural activities, and on dissolving such nutrients, these make their way towards the nearest water bodies and affects the quality of water and boosts the productivity of the phytoplankton and macrophytes in the water body. As a result, the quality of water gets decreased, and on death of such macrophytes and phytoplanktons and zooplanktons consumes amount of dissolved oxygen, which results decrease in quality of dissolved oxygen in the water bodies. Then we have effects of eutrophication. What are the effects of eutrophication? It means once the lake gets converted into a eutrophic lake, then what are the consequences, what are the effects we may observe, we may see. For example, it results increase in biomass of the phytoplankton. It's a natural thing. If productivity of any particular ecosystem is increasing, then no doubt the biomass of the amount of that particular lake or the water body is going to increase. Then toxic or inedible phytoplankton may grow. Inedible means the phytoplanktons which are non-usable in nature, which can't be consumed by human being, means non-edible or toxic phytoplanktons are going to increase in the water body. Then increase in gelatinous zooplanktons means we are actually getting the growth of such organisms which are undesirable in nature for the water body. Increase in benthic and epiphytic alga means if we are having these organisms in any particular water body, these are actually the biological indices of the water body, on the basis of which we can declare that the water body has gone changed from oligotrophic, from mesotrophic to eutrophic stage. Then we have change in macrophytes, means undesirable macrophytes or excessive growth of macrophytes may grow in the water bodies. Then we have decrease in water transparency, because after the growth of the phytoplanktons and other organisms, transparency of the water body gets decreased. For example, if the alga, for example, Azolla is growing on any particular water body, the penetration of sunlight is totally or partially obstructed here, hence no penetration of sunlight to the bottom dwelling plants and no oxygen is produced. It means the transparency of the water body is decreased, which finally results the depletion of oxygen, because no production, no photosynthesis or little photosynthesis activity by the bottom dwelling plants show. So no photosynthesis means no oxygen is produced, hence amount of dissolved oxygen is actually declined, which actually is added or supported by decomposition processes. Then we have decrease in aesthetic value. Aesthetic value simply means a scenic beauty of the lake, how pleasant, how sensory good appeal the lake actually gives us when we go for to see the lake. Then the natural beauty of the lake has actually diminished already, then the aesthetic value of the lake means reduced. Decrease in biodiversity. No doubt, as long as the lake was in mesotrophic, or we can say in oligotrophic stage, different species were there, and especially the desirable species like nectens, fish, etc. But after the lake has got converted into a eutrophic stage, the species, the number of species, the species diversity, we say, is increasing. But we should keep in mind here that a particular type of species number is very much increased, but the diversity of the lake actually gets declined. Biodiversity declined means different number of species were existing prior to the convergence of eutrophication of the lake, but now species of a particular group, that is actually gelatinous zooplanktons or the toxic phytoplanktons or undesirable species or the pathogenic organisms grow tremendously. A particular type of species is increasing its number, but the diversity of the lake actually gets declined. Then we have hypoxia. Actually, less amount of oxygen availability results, especially at the bottom of the lakes, and which results the death of the organisms due to unavailability of the oxygen, and the region is actually known as dead zone in the lake and lies in the bottom of the lake. Hypoxia simply means less amount of availability of oxygen. This was almost all about the eutrophication. Now, hope you understand the meaning of biomagnification. In the next very lecture, we will discuss or continue the other impacts of the water pollution. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Best of luck.